Hello everyone. So this video I will be showing you how to change the data type of a column in SQL. So I'm currently using MySQL Workbench. So let's get started. So here I'm having like a sample code and my table name is MON1. So let me just run this. So it has like two columns. One is R number, which is of type int, and name is of type varchar string. So let me just run it now. So it works fine, and let me just insert some values. So this works fine because here one is of type int, John is of type name varchar, so it just corresponds to that. So now if I just go and type description of my table, okay, so this is because here only we can like get an idea how the data type is getting updated. So now you can see type is of int, type is of varchar, that's absolutely fine. So now let's just go and change our R number, which is of type int, to varchar. Okay, so the syntax is alter table, in fact write table, alter table, then the table name. Okay, it's not alter table name, it's alter table, table name, and here you will be using modify. Okay, so modify and column, and then you are going to write the column name. So here our column name is R number, so R number, and next thing the data type which you are going to change. So it's int right now, so we are going to change it to varchar. So we just have to put varchar and specify the size. So let me just put 2, that's fine. And another important thing that you will note here is that except this and this table name and column name, everything can be in capital letter or small letter, that's not going to affect the code. But this thing, you have to be careful, you have to just replicate the code over here. Okay, so that's it. Now let me just write it up. And I'm getting a green mark over here. So now if I just go to description and run it, I will be getting R number as varchar, which means that our data type has been changed from int to varchar. So now again I can just insert it. Okay, this is not going to do any change. I can still insert an integer value, so I'm still able to insert 1. Okay, but here is the twist. So let's suppose say that I will change my name column into integer. Okay, so now let me show the contents of the table. Okay, select asterisk from 1. So let me just run it now. So here it's having, so now both the columns are of type varchar. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to convert name to R number. Okay, so let me just do it. Really simple, same code. Instead of here, we're just going to put name, and instead of varchar 2, you will be just putting int. Simple. So now let me just run it, and this time I will be getting an error. The reason is because John, if I convert my column name into of type int, then how can John be of type integer? That makes no sense. So this will show you an error. So only way to solve this is you need to just go and delete these two things. John, you need to delete this, and then you need to insert integers. So this won't work. But if I now try to like again change my R number, okay, R number column, which is currently of type varchar, if I now change it to int, it will work perfectly. I will be getting a green mark, and if I just go to description, it will be have converted to int type. So the reason is because in my table of R number column, I'm just having 1. So even though, so let's suppose say 1 is of type varchar and gets converted to of type int, 1 is going to remain 1. Okay, there isn't any change. But John, when it's of type varchar, when it gets converted to integer, it can't be of type int. So that our SQL throws an error. So this is how it works. Okay, so I hope you have found this video useful. My name is a programming channel. I've done many other videos in SQL queries, as well as interview questions, as well as programming videos in C, C++, Java, Python, as well as 3D animation in Blender. So do check out the rest of my channel. Subscribe and support me. Thanks for watching.